Welcome learners to the course Advanced Java Programming from Computer Engineering Program. Today we are going to talk on Chapter 2.3 Buttons, the J buttons, checkboxes, radio buttons from Unit 2nd Swings. Myself G.K. Yadav, lecturer in Computer Engineering Department, Government Polytechnic, Yavatmal. So let's start. After watching this video, the learner will be able to use the given type of button in Java-based GUI, that is graphical user interface. The prerequisites are, before knowing this or before watching this video, the student must know few basic concepts of Windows-based programming, applet, AWT controls, layout managers from the first unit, and again some initial concepts from the second unit regarding what is swing, what are the swing components, JApplet, JFrame, and we are going to use the Java Development Kit in order to execute the programs. So let's start with the swing buttons. As you know that there is one button in the AWT. Like that, swing provides four types of buttons which are named as J button, J toggle button, J checkbox and J radio button. All these four types of buttons, they are the subclasses of abstract button class, which is extended from the J component class. All these buttons share the same set of common trait because they are all the subclasses of an abstract button class, and that's why there are many methods which are common to all these different types of buttons which can be used for handling the different types of behavior of the buttons. This is the hierarchy. So hierarchy is directly given. J component is the root class. It is having one subclass, that is the abstract button, you can see. Now abstract button are having two subclasses, which is J button and J toggle button. So first we will talk about this J button, and then we will move to this J toggle button, which is again having two subclasses, that is J checkbox and J radio button. So let's start with J button. So what is J button? So as you are having the button in AWT, likewise swing is having J button. So J button, it provides the functionality of the push button, and you can have a string, an icon or both associated with that push button, and these are the different constructors given for the J button, that is J button with the string parameter, J button with the icon parameter, J button with the parameter of both string and icon, like that. So here we will first try to execute this in terms of program for your better understanding. So going to write one program here. First of all, we will import package javax.swing, because all the swing controls or the swing components are present in this package. Then I will need import java.applet package, because I am going to use JApplet concept. The swing programs can be executed, you must be knowing, either by using JApplet or by JFrame. So initially we will go with the easier concept, that is the JApplet, and then maybe we will see the JFrame for the remaining portion. And then I am going with the import java.awt package, because from here I will get the layout manager classes. Then we are having applet tag, as we write for basic applet programming. So applet that code, in here we will write the name of our program, that is J button demo. Then width 300 and height 200, then just close this applet tag here, close this comment section, and now public class J button demo extends J applet. Here I will directly write inside the init method public void init. In init, create one object of J button. So J button JP equals to new. So I am using the second constructor with the string parameter, and here I am giving the name, suppose yes, it will be the label displayed over my button. Then add this button to the container, and after that we have to do an additional task in the JApplet, that is setting layout, because for AWT flow layout is the default one, but that is not the case for the JApplets. In JApplet you have to explicitly specify flow layout if you need it. So here flow layout we have given, then close the int method, then close class. Okay, so just save this program. We will try to compile it first, and Java C, JPEG and Java, and if there is no error then we will run it using the applet viewer. So you can see there is no error, warnings can be ignored. Then using applet viewer and running this JApplet. Okay, so here you can see on the output there is one yes button is displayed. Likewise you can implement the button control. Now what is about this icon? Okay, so as you have seen that there is icon, so it is used for the purpose, means most of the time you have seen on some online websites or online portals, they are having very attractive buttons, okay, because they are using some specific icons for that purpose. So we will also try to implement it. So for that purpose, first of all you will need one we will say the image. So here suppose I am having this image already with me, that is the download button, and it is having the extension png. Okay, this location I am having the button itself, so that's why I will make the changes in the program something like this. So here I will create one icon object and initialize it with the image icon, because icon is not a regular class, that's why we cannot create its direct object using new icon. So we are going with the new image icon, and here name of image download dot button, and here extension was png. If your button image is located at some other location, then you will go with this directory address, otherwise directly the name is sufficient, and then pass the object of icon as a parameter to the constructor. Okay, now let's save this program and we will compile it. And then run it. Yes, that's it. So here you can see the button is there, and along with one image over it, that is the icon. Okay, so likewise J button. Now moving ahead, we are after this, you can see there are two types of buttons on the screen. So pause for a few seconds and think what is the difference between these two types of buttons which we generally observe in our real life. Okay, yes, you are right. The first button is a doorbell, that is we say it as a push button or pop-up button, because whenever we press a doorbell, so as soon as you release your finger, automatically it comes back to original position. Okay, and the another button is a two-state button, which is generally used for the fan or the light purposes. That is, once you make it on, so the fan will keep rotating until you do not press it again. Okay, so likewise it is having two state, on or off, or it is represented in diagram as 1 or 0. So once you make it on, it will remain on until you do not press it again. So how it is implemented? It is implemented by the concept of J toggle button in the swing. So a toggle button looks just like a push button, but it acts differently because it has two states, that is pushed and release. As we have talked, on off, that is pushed and release, and J button, J toggle button is a super class for other two swing components as we have already seen in the diagram. And here we will take one constructor from the J toggle button with a string parameter and try to execute it. If you wish to know all the constructors available in any class, so at that time you can simply type here the command java p, then type the name of package javax.swing and then name of that class for which you are interested to see all the constructors and method available. So we have given here jtoggle buttons. Now you can see there are number of constructors available and these are the different methods available in the jtoggle button. But we will, for our simple understanding here, I will come back to the previous, that is I will remove the icon and I will make it as a simple yes button. Now we will take another button which will be the jtoggle button. So you can compare nicely between these two buttons. Here new jtoggle button, I will write here on off button. After that just add it jtoggle button jtb, that is the object name. Now save this program. Compile. And run it. Okay. So see that both the buttons are look similar, but how they behave differently. This one is the J button. So I am pressing it and releasing it. So I am pressing it and again it is coming back to its original position. That is, it is popping up. Okay, now this one is the J toggle button on off. So see what happens when I press it. So I have pressed it. So see that it is in the pressed state. Okay, you can observe the change in the color. So if I will say I have made it on, so it will remain on until I do not press it again. Okay, likewise, this is not the case with the first button. See, pressing it will coming back to its position, but here it is still pressed. Now I will again click it and it will come back to its another state. Okay, so likewise you can see this is the push state and this is the release state, likewise. Okay, now we will see the remaining two subclasses of this jtoggle button. So this is the checkboxes. You must be knowing the basics of checkbox from the AWT unit, that here we know that when we are having multiple choices to select at a time, at that time we go with the checkbox control. So here J checkbox class is provided to provide the functionality of checkbox. It is the immediate super class of jtoggle button as we have seen initially in the hierarchy, and it is also defining the several constructor. Out of that we are using this one here as an example, and now we can see the program, execute this program with the jframe, the another approach. So if we go javax.swing, this is the common package for all swing controls, whether you go with the japlet or jframe. Then here import java.awt, there is no need of java.applet package because we are not going with the applet concept, we are going with the simple frame. So now I will write public class here check demo and extends jframe. Okay, here you write first the constructor check demo, and in this constructor create the object of checkbox, suppose C, we will say then new checkbox. So here suppose if we are writing about the different habits, so or the interest, so reading and taking. Okay, then another one, if you want checkbox, you can create here, it will be the C1 new C, here it will be the capital new, then checkbox, and here suppose another copy is here same, it is the another copy. So now we will add this tool in the container of JFrame. Add here C1 like this, and then set layout. Because again, for frame we have to set the layout explicitly. So set your layout, and then set receiver. Because for frame we have to set visible true. We will set size of the frame 200, 300. Okay, then we will go to the main method, public static void main string args, then create the object of check demo. So here you can directly write new check demo, name of class plus. Okay, so this is something anonymous object concept. So now just save this program. We will compile it. Java C, check demo Java. Let's see, is there any error warning? No error, no warning. And then we will run it by using the Java command. Java check demo. Okay, so you can see here output, we are having the two check boxes. So here I can check reading and I can also check sync at a time. Okay, so when we want to select more than one, okay, at that time we go with the checkbox control. So very clear. Now you can also apply the concept of icon etc. by using the different constructors, or if you want to that reading should be always selected, so that is also possible. For that purpose you have to explore the remaining constructors from the JCheckBox class. Okay, move to the next one here, that is after check boxes we are having the last type of button for our today's discussion, that is the radio buttons. So radio buttons are a group of mutually exclusive buttons in which only one button can be selected at any one time. So as we know that on the radio which we used to play in our general life, there are multiple frequencies or the channels available, but how many channels you can play at one time? Okay, it's only one. So from that concept the name is given radio button, that at one time you can select only one, that we are saying it is mutually exclusive. Okay, if there are three radio buttons, one is selected, then you will going to select second one, automatically first one get unselected. Okay, likewise, that is at one time you can select only one. This is generally used to take the gender of a person from the login forms or the sign up form. Okay, so then they are supported by JRadio button class, which extends the JToggle button, which we already see in the hierarchy. And JRadio button provides several constructors, out of which we are going to take one as an example here, that is JRadio button with the string parameter. Go and make the changes in the existing program. Okay, so now I will remove this all, and now I am going to put the JRadio button. So JRadio button, suppose here JRB1 plus to new JRadio button. Suppose I am taking here gender, so it is male, and JRadio button JRB, and it is JRadio button, and here we are having second JRadio button with the label female. Now add this JRadio button 1 in the container, add JRadio button 2 in the container, and then set layout here new flow layout, then set size 200, 300, and then set visible true. Okay, then rest program will remain as it is. We will save this program and just compile it. Run. Okay, so here is our output with the two JRadio button, that is male and female. And you can select this likewise, and we will try to select this, and we hope that as it is the JRadio button, so there should be mutually exclusive selection. Means if I am going to select female, automatically male should be get unselected. Okay, that is my assumption. So here I am selecting female. But what happened in this case, that male is, it is not getting unselected automatically. Okay, so how to implement this concept? So we have just displayed the JRadio button on the screen, but actually the idea behind JRadio button is not being yet implemented. So for that purpose, we need to some extent our exclusive nature to be activated. Radio buttons must be configured into a group. Means we have to take all these JRadio buttons inside a single group. We have to bring them under one umbrella from where we can check their mutually exclusive nature. A button group is created by the button group class, and its default constructor is invoked for this purpose. So we are going to create one class object, that is a class is button group already available. We are going to create its object, and then elements are added to the button group via the following method, that is add. Okay, so we have already used one add method, but that was from the container class. Here this add button is from the button group class. Okay, so let's implement this concept in our program. So here I will create an object of button group class, button group. So pg equals to new button group class. This is the same class which you have already used in AWT for the purpose of getting the radio button from checkboxes in AWT. Okay, now go on adding them in the button group. So that's why bg.add. So bg indicates this is the object of button group. So bg.add means this add method. This add method, it is from which class? It is from the button group class. So here I am going to add jrb1, that is the first radio button is added in the button group class. Then another one, add jbr2. Okay, so this addition is for the getting the mutually exclusive nature. Okay, then for displaying them on the container, these add methods are used. This add method is from which class? It is from the container class. Okay, so now see what is the changes in our output. And run it. Okay, so here is your output. So now I will select first one, and when I am selecting second one, I hope it should get automatically unselected. Okay, so select second one and see, it is getting unselected. First one, it is automatically getting unselected. So likewise, they are being selected mutually exclusive manner, JRadio buttons. Okay, then here are the references that we have used for the creation of this video. Thank you very much. Thanks for watching. If you have any query, please contact right on my phone. Thank you very much.